When Welcome to Plathville premiered in 2019, fans were smitten with the stars and all the drama in the Plath family, particularly with Olivia and Ethan Plath, who had to deal with a whole lot when it came to his family. While the two seem truly in love, what's the truth about their marriage? One of the things that make the Plath family unique is their ultra-conservative worldviews. In the series premiere of Welcome to Plathville, it's established that the Plaths try to keep their kids as far removed from the modern world as possible.
We've structured our lifestyle here so that we can retreat to our piece of heaven on earth.
They don't watch television or use the internet for anything other than schooling. And matriarch Kim Plath has even outlawed added sugar or any kind of junk food in the family home. Ethan Plath first met Olivia at a conservative family camp, after which they stayed in contact by old-fashioned letter writing. On their wedding website, they wrote, "Within a few weeks of returning home, Ethan couldn't get Olivia off of his mind and decided that he was completely smitten." But it wasn't until 2 years later that their letter correspondence started, and they developed mutual feelings for each other. Clearly, their love story was a long time coming. Because Olivia and Ethan Plath weren't exactly raised like most American kids, their love story wasn't exactly like most people's. Their parents were both pretty conservative, and because they didn't live near each other, they had to keep things G-rated and get their parents' approval. The pair didn't really fall for each other until they were granted the permission to spend time together in person. And according to the couple's wedding website, that happened about 2.5 years after they first met. Olivia described her visit with the Plath family. She said, "I spent 2 weeks in Georgia with the Plath family and we were finally able to go on our first date." It might not be the stereotypical love story for most people, but clearly, Ethan and Olivia made the most of their unusual circumstances. If you've watched even just one episode of Welcome to Plathville, then you know that, after being married for a while, Olivia Plath's relationship with her in-laws wasn't exactly sunshine and glitter.
Family problems like these really can strain marriages to the point that they just break and people give up on each other.
But as it turns out, Olivia actually enjoyed being with Ethan Plath's family when they first started dating. And since Ethan and Olivia got married, there must have been a point where Olivia and the Plaths actually liked each other, right? Well, Olivia wrote in her family's old blog that when she first met and got to know the Plath family, she totally got along with them. The blog post described Olivia's family and the Plaths. In it, she wrote, "Indulging in quality time, late-night shenanigans, sharing testimonies, dancing and reeling, washing dishes, hiking, playing music, and talking and laughing galore." Additionally, Olivia referred to the Plaths as being, quote, "her people." But clearly that wasn't always the case.
And I felt like if I did not conform and think exactly like you guys or do things like you guys, I wasn't accepted.
While so much has changed since then, the fact that Olivia initially got along with Ethan's family, at least somewhat, helps to explain why the pair got together in the first place. Olivia and Ethan Plath seem like an adorable couple. While Ethan's innocence made their relationship even cuter, and the video Olivia took of him trying a Coke for the first time was highly entertaining. Quite possibly nothing could top his proposal to Olivia. After 3 years of knowing each other and most of their relationship being long distance, Ethan surprised Olivia with the most thoughtful proposal ever. As Olivia wrote on their wedding website, she was totally surprised by Ethan's grand gesture. Olivia explained that the two went out for dinner at a special garden, which was actually where they had their first real date and really got to know each other. She wrote, "That's where Ethan got down on one knee, told Olivia he couldn't live without her, and asked her to be his wife." For several reasons, after Olivia and Ethan Plath tied the knot, the couple's relationship with the Plath family seriously started to disintegrate. Because Ethan's parents, Kim and Barry, didn't approve of the way Ethan and Olivia were living their lives, they started to restrict Ethan and Olivia's access to his siblings.
"We are a family, but this is two households, and that is extremely important to me."
As Olivia said in a scene during season 2 of Welcome to Plathville, things with Ethan's parents took a turn for the worse when they were denied seeing his siblings without his parents chaperoning the interaction. As Welcome to Plathville made clear, Kim and Barry apparently didn't trust their oldest son and his wife not to corrupt their children by drinking Coke and watching television.
"During last year, we were allowed to see the kids some, and then last fall, everything just completely changed. We were not allowed to see the kids at all."
One of the hardest obstacles that Olivia and Ethan Plath had to face in their marriage was that the Plath family rules didn't sit right with Olivia. And since she didn't agree with them, there was some tension between Kim and Barry Plath and their new daughter-in-law. She expressed it this way: "Since we got married, it's just been like a long process of introducing him to all these different things. Obviously, we're a family, and we're going to do things the way that we choose to do them. And we allow a lot of different things in our home that his parents wouldn't."
Just got to the point of like, if this is gonna work, we're gonna have to fight really hard for this and cut out everything that doesn't want us to make it.
Clearly, Olivia didn't agree with the Plath family rules, and who could blame her? On season one of Welcome to Plathville, Olivia and Ethan Plath appeared to try to make things work with Ethan's family, while they were only allowed to be around Ethan's siblings sometimes, and usually only while supervised. The couple still tried to stay in touch with the Plaths. However, things ended up getting so bad in the time between season one's end and season two's start that the two had to make a tough decision in regards to Ethan's family.
There was a day 3 or 4 months ago that Ethan came over to our house and told us he wanted nothing to do with us ever again.
Ethan explained that, "Since last year, a lot has happened in our relationship between me and Olivia and my parents and my siblings. Just the family dynamics. It really does hurt. I have a lot of frustration that I'm trying to deal with." Then Ethan revealed that the couple had made a tough choice in order to save their relationship. He said they needed space as a couple and decided that meant no contact with his parents. No one who gets married ever expects to get divorced or to even have to talk about getting divorced. But for Olivia and Ethan Plath, the pressures from their reality show and especially from the Plath family made it nearly impossible not to discuss splitting up.
Divorce was definitely on the table for a couple of months, and it was a really hard couple of months.
She also noted, "And just got to the point of like, if this is gonna work, we're gonna have to fight really hard for this and cut out everything that doesn't want us to make it." It seems as though Ethan and Olivia needed to focus on each other, and so stepping back from the Plath family drama helped them do that. Olivia added, "I think as we heal as people, our marriage will begin to heal and thrive." The year 2020 was a tough one for just about everyone, and for Olivia and Ethan Plath, 2020 had them spending even more time together, though that wasn't always a good thing. In the second episode of season 2 of Welcome to Plathville, Ethan and Olivia have a little issue in the kitchen where she's trying to get some work done, and he is having a hard time making pancakes. It was pretty tense between the two, as Olivia explained that, due to the COVID-19 pandemic, her job had to slow down and she was at home more. Still, while they got used to more and more of each other's company, they also learned to enjoy it. In an Instagram post from August 2020, Olivia shared just how happy she was spending more time with Ethan. She wrote in the caption, "Thankful for a quiet downtown so we could get ice cream and talk on the bench for a while. I guess one good thing about 2020 is that COVID has helped me to not take those little moments for granted. If the coronavirus can't take those two down, nothing can." In case you didn't know by now, the Plath family on Welcome to Plathville is incredibly strict. Ethan Plath, then, was raised to avoid certain foods, music, shows, and clothes. And you can bet that he was also taught to avoid tattoos. However, in season 2 of Welcome to Plathville, Ethan and Olivia Plath cemented their marriage in a whole new way when they got matching tattoos. In the episode, Ethan was a lot more nervous than Olivia at the thought of getting a tattoo.
"I walk in and I didn't know what to say. I was shocked, absolutely shocked."
Ethan had said he never wanted one until he met Olivia, and he even second-guessed his decision. In the end, they went for it, for the most romantic reason. Ethan said, "We thought it was something that was like cute and kind of like romantic to each have something from the other, I guess." The tattoos, Olivia got a Queen of Hearts tattoo while Ethan was inked with a King of Hearts, were definitely a symbol of their relationship, and evidence that they've both escaped their controlling upbringings. One of the biggest surprises on season 2 of Welcome to Plathville was when Ethan and Olivia Plath looked at buying another home in a neighboring city in order to put some distance between themselves and Ethan's family. But as it turns out, they've given it a lot of thought, and for Ethan and Olivia, moving away from their small Georgia town is pretty important. In an interview with People, Olivia explained that while Welcome to Plathville did show a little of their journey to move, it wasn't the whole picture.
"Have you heard from the realtor yet?"
"Yeah. We didn't get the house, someone else got it."
She told People about relocating.
I think we definitely will go over the border into Florida. On the show, everyone saw us go look at a house, and we both honestly loved that house. And I was really heartbroken when it fell through, because it kind of felt like a nail in a coffin of, oh, okay, I am stuck here. In the end, Olivia said it was for the best, because the house was only 30 minutes away, which wasn't far enough from Ethan's family, in their opinion.
I just don't want to raise kids in a place like this. I don't want to raise kids in a place where I'm scared to go to the grocery store.
In the season 2 finale of Welcome to Plathville, viewers got an up-close look at just how tense things were between Ethan Plath and his parents, Kim and Barry Plath. When Ethan went to their house to say goodbye to his younger siblings, he badly wanted his brother and sisters to say goodbye to Olivia, who was waiting in the car just across the way, too.
I'd like to say goodbye to them, say goodbye to you. This isn't a debate or conversation. This is my statement to you.
But his parents just wouldn't let them go to the car, and things escalated. At one point, both Kim and Barry tried to go see Olivia, something Ethan was adamant shouldn't happen. And Ethan was so adamant, in fact, that he almost came to blows with his father.
It is very nice of you to say that you love me, but behind my back, when you talk about my wife to other people, it's not gonna fly with me.
Moments later, Barry took off towards the car, and Ethan had to forcibly grab him and talk sternly to him in order to protect his wife. It was seriously tense, but it showed just how much Ethan had grown and how he had learned to stand up for his wife. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite TV shows are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.